Lanny Griffin was a proud spokesman for the Obama administration's health care overhaul. Watch this.
With the new health care law, more good things are coming. Free checkups, lower prescription costs, and better ways to protect us and Medicare from fraud.
The ads appear innocent enough, but it turns out the ads were not only misleading, they also cost taxpayers $3 million. Judicial Watch Director of Investigations Christopher Farrell's in Washington, D.C. Chris, you know, I mean, when you see Andy Griffith, you just take for granted what he's saying is gospel and good for you.
You hope that the sheriff of Mayberry isn't lying to you.
That's right. So, as it turns out, maybe Barney Fife was the one who put the ads together.
It seems that way. What's really disturbing, though, is that the Obama administration took $3 million in taxpayer money and involved their own campaign spokesperson, a woman named Catherine McLean, and got Porter Novelli in on the contract, and everybody got a check except the American people. They took $3 million in taxpayer money, developed a false and misleading ad, put it out to the public as a propaganda campaign right before an election. These ads aired in large part in September and October. And so everybody gets a check. It's Chicago-style politics, and the taxpayers left on the hook for ads that are false and misleading.
Chris, I don't understand the process, so forgive me for that, but I don't understand how $3 million, $300 of taxpayer money could ever be spent on a political commercial that is basically saying, look, it's us versus them, left versus right, or right versus left. I don't understand how taxpayer dollars can be used for that.
Yeah, and this is a case, once again, where the left uses a Hollywood figure who's either, you know, sort of a true believer or a dupe, somebody who's, you know, being used to promote a political agenda under the guise of it being a government educational promotional, and it's neither. In fact, folks involved or enrolled in the Medicare Advantage plan will see their benefits cut by anywhere from $40 to $60 a month. And, of course, you know, the Obamacare provision itself cut $500 million out of Medicare. So they play this weasel word game where they say that, oh, your guaranteed coverage is going to be there. That's true. Those elements that are guaranteed by law. All the other stuff, hey, good luck. We'll see how it turns out.
Well, you see with political ads all the time, you can get them pulled when they're factually incorrect. You just pointed out an inaccuracy that the fact check director and a bunch of GOP senators pointed out a long time ago. How did this ad continue to run and how did money still get wasted on it?
Precisely. I mean, the Wall Street Journal, factcheck.org, I think your own networks, Eric Bolling, any number of different organizations have questioned it. That's why we at Judicial Watch went after the records. We've made the records available. They're on our website at judicialwatch.org. Folks can look and read them, read for themselves the money that went into this. And the involvement of an Obama political campaign spokesperson who now works at Porter Novelli, of course, somehow they got a check to help develop the ads. So there's any number of errors and flaws and really ethical questions tied in with this. But the bottom line is there's supposedly a government educational ad that's being aired that's false, and the American people paid for it as a propaganda tool.
Chris, this is Tracy Burns. You know what the problem here is to me? It makes me more of a skeptic. I'm a Sicilian skeptic to begin with. I don't believe anything anybody says now, and I think that's very sad because there's only certain ways we could disseminate information out to the American people. And unfortunately, ads is one of them. And if you just turn your TV on thinking, I don't believe anything I see, no one is actually going to understand the truth ever.
Yeah, and it, again, it's this sort of reckless use of this. It's sort of an iconic figure. I mean, Andy Griffith is this lovable old sheriff from Mayberry RFD, and I don't know whether he's fully witting or not.
That's the thing. I don't think we blame Andy. I think Andy just read his lines because he needed the money to pay the bills.
He did it for free. He did it
See,
for free.
See, there you go. Well, Chris, between
you and I, first of all, I want to thank you because this is important, even though the animals have left the barn, you know, we're closing the door. But we got to know about this. The public must be educated. And as far as Andy is concerned, I'm only hoping he's one of those guys that were duped, to your earlier point. Appreciate your time this morning.
Thank you very much.